Adam and Eve were not only the first humans on the Earth. They were bait for intelligent life forms elsewhere in the cosmos, refugees from planets that could no longer sustain them. But why Earth? Deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA, the blueprint of human life, is the key to their survival. Without it, they will perish. The first encounters between humans and extraterrestrials took place over 100,000 years ago in Atlantis and in its sister civilization in the Pacific, Lemuria. Ancient civilizations on every continent have recorded evidence of these encounters. These visitors were highly advanced and did not appear in human form. Now, the Mayans called them Chanes, people of the serpents. And in Hebrew legend, the snake represented knowledge. Of course it did. It was not human. Not of this earth.
Catherine, check this out. Take a look at this.
Hey, isn't that the...
Yeah. You can see Dick Cheney, Al Gore, all 9 Supreme Court justices shapeshift into reptilians. Did you know that for thousands of years, creatures from the constellation Draco have been mating with humans to form a super race that includes 43 U.S. presidents, most members of Congress, and the entire British royal family?
So it's a kind of conspiracy.
Exactly, yeah.
So who are these people at the top that are keeping you down?
Oh, just people at the top, generally.
No, I'm serious. This is important. Who are the people at the top?
Did you slay the reptilian Athena?
I did what I had to do.
What's this all about?
I have to kill you.
What?
Well, the channel controllers.
But who's controlling them, Rick? Think about it. Who's controlling everything?
Everything? It's the government.
They're just puppets. Higher.
The Queen?
Oh,
America.
Higher.
Oh, God. No, not God. I mean, not God. Is it Google?
Not even close, Rick. Not even close.
So Connor's cut off her head because he thought she was a serpent from outer space?
It's the shape-shifting lizards.
Oh, God. I was forgetting about them.
There is an elite cabal of shape-shifting lizards who control every major government and every media network on the planet.
Shapeshifting, is it?
Yep.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And I have to ask you this question. There's a rumor that you have not washed your hair in days and days and weeks, and to me it looks like your hair looks good. What's the deal with the shampoo?
I don't know. I think I don't really know. I don't really know where all these things come from. I think I say things and then I'm not really thinking at the time, and then I get asked the question again, and then I make it up more and more and more, like 6 weeks, I haven't washed my hair for 4 years. I just don't understand, you know, what where all these things come from.
So occasionally you are washing your hair?
I mean, occasionally, when it gets unbearable, when I have, like, mites and stuff.
We are victims, and no one is listening to us. We're powerless against what's going on. We're not crazy. And if you look at who's had contact, we're airline pilots, professionals, teachers, scientists. I don't know how to get the truth out, but we have to.
Has anyone talked to Shannon in the last couple of days?
They've got it.
It's like we're witnessing some form of mass hallucination. You know, they think the cops are part of this reptilian conspiracy as well. That's why Shannon attacked Greg.
Let's try this again.
History is replete with stories of the heroic destruction of serpents. Perseus and Medusa, St. George and the Dragon, St. Patrick and the Snakes of Ireland. These are not merely legends. These are accounts of battles for the survival of the human race. A battle we will lose unless we stop killing one another and focus on the real enemies. They are among us.